to go over the mathematics of both dilation and erosion, we have to talk about something called the structuring element, okay? The structuring element is a mask, okay? It's a shape that you're going to use to do these operations. And it can be any shape. For today, the shapes are going to be just ones and zeros. They can also be ones, zeros, and X's, and the X's are don't cares. But nothing we're going to talk about today will involve don't cares, so I'm not going to talk about it. What's important about the shape is that they all are defined with respect to sometimes called an anchor or a reference point or an origin, right? And usually, not always, usually that origin is in the middle of whatever shape you're making use of, okay? So given a structuring element, we can define both dilation and erosion. So dilation is as follows. Basically, I've got some binary image, B, okay, and that's here. I've got a structuring element, S, and the structuring element has to have an origin. Basically, what you do is you're going to take this dilation structuring element and you're going to run it around here, placing the origin at different places. And wherever you place it, you're going to take the OR of all of the ones in the structuring element with the ones underneath it. And so what that means is if any of the ones land, of the structuring element land on a one in the binary image, the OR of all that will be one. So Arpan did this and he's very proud. So there's my structuring element and there he goes, meow, very good, cool. All right, so you basically run it all over and what the result of this, okay, is this thing here. And let's just take a look at that, right? These are our two original ones, okay? So when I put this structuring element down here, like that, nothing was a one. In fact, as I slide it all along, nothing is a one, so those are all zeros, right? But when I put my structuring element here, notice it overlaps there, okay? So this value, which is the origin for that first position, that gets a one. And as I slide it along, that's how I get the rest of these. So that's dilation by a particular shape. Now, I will tell you, sometimes you'll dilate by sort of a funny shape like that. Usually your shape will be symmetric. Sometimes it'll be taller than it is wide because you're trying to extend things in one direction as opposed to another. But this cutout kind of thing would be a little bit unusual. In fact, here's a nice example. So here's a binary text. And you can see that there's white pixels, but they've got lots of, you know, if you take a look at that M, you can see it's kind of a bunch of little spots in there that seem to have some holes in it. So if I use a structuring element that looks like this, that essentially says if I touch anybody to my right, left, up, or below, I want to turn on the pixel. And when I do that, you get the really much better result, right? I mean, it's much easier to read the one on the left than one on the right. The one on the right might be uglier, okay, because it doesn't look so crisp, but there's no question about reading it.